A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 12th Jan, Sunday. On the front page you have, Iran admits its missile shot down Ukraine jet. So this was a strike down on a Ukrainian jet. It was a Boeing jet which killed all 176 people on board, and majority of them were Iranians, and also second majority were Canadians. So Canadian Prime Minister Justin Trudeau had said that it is Iran who is behind this attack on this targeting the Ukrainian jet, and now Iran itself has admitted that its missile shot down the Ukrainian passenger jet. So President Hassan Rouhani of Iran has said military probe into the tragedy had found missile fired due to human error brought down the Boeing 737, calling it an unforgivable mistake. So this is in the context of escalation of tensions between Iran and USA on killing of Iranian military general in Iraq, which was in news. Then here you have, this is H2O Holy Faith, a 90-story complex at Maradu near Kochi, which has been brought down by implosion. So this was violating CRZ norms, coastal regulatory zone norms, and Supreme Court ordered bringing it down. So this demolition has taken place. Then below you have, India amends rules for US airlines. So in an effort to resolve persistent concerns of the US, India has made exception for American Airlines on its ground handling regulations that prohibit international carriers from operations beyond the check-in areas. So this exception will be provided to America. So American Airlines will be allowed to have interactions beyond operations beyond the check-in area too. But then these airlines will have to allow a security audit by Indian agencies and ensure that Indian employees are tasked with sensitive operations. And below you have, Bangladesh minister cancels Delhi visit. So this is the fourth official visit from Bangladesh which has been called off since December 2019. So reasons given are varied, like here it is said the minister had to be with the prime minister on her visit abroad, so that's why he cancelled his visit to India. But then reasons may be because of Bangladesh's concerns with respect to Citizenship Amendment Act and NRC, which India proposes to implement, which is going to affect Bangladesh because the illegal migrants which are being targeted are feared to be majorly from Bangladesh. So it will have consequences on Bangladesh too. On page 9 you have, light combat aircraft Navy variant successfully lands on INS Vikramaditya. So this is LCA MK1, which has successfully completed the first arrested landing on the aircraft carrier INS Vikramaditya. So these huge ships, you can say, which are called aircraft carriers. So the indigenously built aircraft, Navy variant, has successfully made landing on it too. So technologies specific to deck-based fighter jet operations have been proven in this test. Then below you have, Transgender Persons Act comes into effect. So this is regarding the act which has been notified now on Jan 10, 2019, which is Transgender Persons Prohibition of Rights Act 2019. So it has been passed by both the Houses of Parliament and has got presidential assent too. And now finally it has been notified. The act, it says, aims to end discrimination against transgender persons in accessing education, employment and healthcare. It also recognizes right to self-perceived gender identity and provides for certification from a district magistrate. So here there was some controversy because of certification coming from district magistrate. So because then it is that the district magistrate would decide whether a person is transgender or not, or which gender he or she belongs to. So in case a transgender person has had a gender change surgery, the law says they can obtain a certificate from the medical facility where they had the operation and apply for a change in their certificate too. But then there are concerns raised regarding requirement of this certificate. That's the main opposition to this act as such now. Earlier it was a bill. So this is there. So now it has been notified. On page 10 you have, 34 lakh OCI cards issued, center. So Ministry of Home Affairs has declined to give information on number of persons whose cards were cancelled. But it has said that more than 34 lakh OCI registrations have been done as such. So it says regarding how many have been cancelled, there is non-availability of the figure in a consolidated form, is what the Ministry of Home Affairs said. So overseas citizens of India, They offer eligible persons of Indian origin multiple entry lifelong visa to India. So, OCI card holders have parity with NRIs in financial, economic, and educational fields except in acquiring agricultural property. But then citizens from two countries, Pakistan and Bangladesh, are not eligible to apply for OCI. So, there are some recent relaxations also given under OCI holders, like for children and spouse of foreign military personnel or police personnel, either in service or retired, have been made eligible for consideration for registration as OCI too. Then similar relaxations for even foreign nationals working in private security agencies. So such relaxations have been given so that more provisions are provided to OCI card holders. But then the number of such requests rejected, that issue, that response has not been given under RTI by the Ministry of Home Affairs. On page 11, you have, we won't leave Siachen, says Army Chief. So, the Chief of Army Staff, General Narwane, has said that the Army would not disengage from the Siachen Glacier, which is the world's highest battlefield, and it is under control of India. So, he says it is key to deterring a two-front engagement with Pakistan and China. So, this has been clearly stated. Though it is a costly affair, the climate over there at such a height is not hospitable. But the army continues to have its presence there, and that has been backed by the army chief too. Then below you have Rongali Bihu artists decry order on check payments. So GST authority, Goods and Services Tax Authority of Assam, has asked Bihu communities across Assam to make all transactions including payment to artists through check. So Rongali Bihu is a major source of income for singers, musicians, comedians and actors, etc., who are associated with entertainment in Assam. So they have been asked to make payments in checks, which has raised protests here. The reason for this being that if check payments are made, they will have to pay GST, because then there will be no cash transactions and GST will compulsorily be have to be paid at every transaction. Then on international page you have Ukraine demands justice compensation. So this is regarding the front page news being continued when Iran has admitted that it has mistakenly shot down Ukrainian civilian aircraft. So then Ukraine is demanding for compensation. Then this is regarding Qaboos, the Sultan who shielded Oman from regional turmoil. He was the longest reigning ruler in the Arab world. So he passed away as such on Friday. This is Libya talks will be held in Berlin. So this is regarding talks on Libya. There are warring factions in Libya which need to enter into a ceasefire. So that is being tried by international actors. So German Chancellor Angela Merkel has said that Libyan peace talks will be held in Berlin in Germany, as Turkey and Russia have appealed to Libya's warring factions to enter a ceasefire. So UN will lead the meet. So that has been put forth. So this will be, this was said by German Chancellor Angela Merkel in her joint press conference with Russian President Vladimir Putin. And this is Taiwan. In Taiwan, the elections saw the Taiwanese leader winning a second term for herself in rebuke to Beijing, China. So China claims Taiwan to be part of its own territory under One China policy. So, but Taiwan claims independence. As such, but many international countries do not recognize Taiwan. Many call it Chinese Taipei. So that is there. Then on business page you have, won't back fiscal tightening currently. So this is Nobel laureate Abhijit Banerjee, who delivered a lecture at this Tata Institute of Social Science, and he said that fiscal tightening, in the sense that government has a fiscal deficit, means government is borrowing more to take care of its spendings. So when more borrowing is taking place, the fiscal deficit numbers increase. But Mr. Abhijit Banerjee says that these deficit numbers are a bit imaginary and it is not a big deal if they are breached. So, fiscal tightening in the present economic scenario will be disastrous, is what he intends to say. So, government if stops spending and tightens its purse, then further the economy is going to deteriorate. Then on Sundays you have FAQ coverage. So, important issues over the week are covered here. So, the first one is, how is the Iran air crash being probed? So this is regarding air accident which took place in which a Ukrainian airline was brought down. So what is the protocol on air accidents? How does the black box help? And what happens if a country admits there has been a mistake? So all these questions are answered in this article. And this is regarding the news which we had, Indian cobra genome mapped. So will the genome sequencing of the poisonous snake help in discovering new broad-based antivenoms? So this question is answered here. So how the genome sequencing of the Indian cobra would be beneficial is mentioned. You can see among the genes identified, there are 19 venom specific ones, and scientists claim that this knowledge can be used to help design better drugs. And this is regarding bushfires in Australia. It says, why are bushfires raging in Australia? What role did the delayed retreat of the Indian monsoon play on the climate of the southern continent? So this is regarding climate change as such too. So what role did it play? The Indian monsoon retreat was delayed. So what consequences it had for climate in the southern continent, in the southern hemisphere, in Australia? So it is discussed here. Then on Sundays, you also have science and technology coverage. So here the first article is, new method better estimates melting of debris covered Himalayan glaciers. So the debris partially insulates the glacier from warm exteriors, thereby slowing down the melting. So this is study of the melting of the glacier, in which researchers planted 60 bamboo stakes below 4600 meter elevation, so that the melting of the glacier can be partially halted. And this is, India should lead in the fight against multi-drug resistant pathogens. So multi-drug resistance is an important issue and topic. So these multi-drug resistant germs, they sicken almost 3 million people across the world every year. And how India has a major stake here, and how it can lead in this fight against multi-drug resistant pathogens is detailed out here. And this is, species rich forests offer stable carbon capture. So teak, eucalyptus plants, they have 43% and 55% less carbon storage than natural forests respectively, is what this article says. So species-rich evergreen forests store carbon at approximately 300 tons per hectare. So they are much more beneficial. So that is there. Then on Sundays in the Hindu newspaper, you also have dispatches coverage in which important international news over the week is covered. So the first one here is regarding Sri Lanka. So the newly inducted president, Gotabaya Rajapaksa, his administration's most reversed Sri Sena's symbolic gesture towards Tamils. So what Gotabaya Rajapaksa has done is that the previous government, which had symbolically allowed the anthem, Sri Lankan national anthem, to be sung in Tamil, so he has reversed that decision now. So that shows that the policy, how the policy of the present government would be towards the Tamils. And then below you have, after Soleimani's killing, Russia moves to push its agenda in West Asia. So Russia has now intends to position itself as a reliable ally to all countries, in contrast to the United States. So in US-Iran conflict, Russia is claiming a role for itself. And this is, amid escalating US-Iran tensions, Afghans fear getting ensnared. So US-Iran tensions are escalating, but Afghanistan also has concerns here, because Afghanistan maintains close ties with both USA and Iran. The Quds force used Iranian fighters also in its anti-Islamic State battle. So this is regarding homeless in Brazil now. So it is said homeless families have increased about 16 times in Brazil. They are sleepless, penniless and hopeless. So that is it. Then further you have sports related news. So these were the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.